Governor Cuomo and Bill de Blasio are pandering to the leftist mob and compromising community safety, period. And this is what happens when you care about the abiding by your leftist extremist ideologies instead of caring about really helping the citizens.
Joining me now is New York State Assemblyman Mike LiPetri. He's also running for Congress in the state's second congressional district. Mike, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you so much for having me, Steph.
And for those of you watching, please don't forget to like and subscribe to The Daily Caller. Now, New York City is approaching phase two amid the coronavirus pandemic. And I know that in your area, you're about to approach phase three. What is phase two going to look like in New York City? And how did phase two go in your area?
Yeah, well, that's the thing. People are aching to come back into the world and being able to live their lives as it was pre-COVID-19. So what it's going to be looking like is businesses opening up, people starting to flock into businesses. And what I'm most afraid of, actually, is where we'll have an overcrowding because people have been kept up in their own homes for so many months. You know, bear in mind that it was my position that weeks and weeks ago, we should have had an opening up of Long Island's economy, New York City's economy, and New York State's economy as a whole, so people can live their lives, make their own decisions, the freedom to choose whether or not they want to go out into the world. If you don't want to go out, fine, stay home. But those that wish to go out, work, make a living, put food on the table for their families, let them do just that.
Well, and I heard Governor Cuomo was basically threatening businesses if they don't follow the rules that he might shut things down again.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. He's not governor anymore. It's King Cuomo for him. And he's the epitome of hypocrisy. This is somebody that threatens to pull liquor licenses, to shut down businesses, those who don't afford social distancing, but yet let thousands gather in Brooklyn for a so on and so forth, quote, demonstration. I mean, how does that make sense? You know, this is exactly why I'm running for Congress over in the South Shore of Long Island, is to restore this common sense in the country and prioritize those who work hard and play by the rules.
Do you think it's a little bit hypocritical that some of the same lawmakers and health experts and officials who were condemning the anti-lockdown protesters, there weren't that many of them, but I remember a few people being arrested for protesting because they were a risk for their community and they were selfish and the name calling list goes on. But then the same lawmakers and health officials didn't really have a lot to say about the riots, the protesters, the protests that are actually still happening in places in New York, including New York City.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, this is pure viewpoint discrimination. Whatever is going to advance the leftist agenda, you're going to see these elected officials are okay with. But then those that harm their agenda, then they're going to be able to condemn and they're going to be trying to put behind bars. It's not fair and it's not right. And that's exactly why we have to have our voices heard that step up for law-abiding Americans. That's what it's about. I mean, these people, I haven't seen anybody that's demonstrating in these streets be fined. Those people that were ignoring social distancing, those who were refusing to wear their masks, they weren't fined. But yet the one who wants to just say, open up so I can put food on the table, that's the one that's put behind bars. It's just wrong.
Yeah. And so, as I mentioned, the protests are still happening. Maybe they're not as big as they were a few weeks ago, but they're still happening. And there is the effort to defund police. That's what these protesters want. A lot of them, that's what they want. They also want police reform. And we have Governor Cuomo and also New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio, who are basically bowing to the protesters and have either promised action or are already in the process of that. I saw that they wanted to cut in New York City, I think it was $1 billion.
Correct.
Police department there. They also got rid of the anti-crime unit. 600 undercover officers citywide will no longer be working this anti-crime patrols. Does this concern you?
I mean, absolutely. It's Governor Cuomo and Bill de Blasio are pandering to the leftist mob and compromising community safety, period. And this is what happens when you care about the abiding by your leftist extremist ideologies instead of caring about really helping the citizens. Because ultimately, 600 plainclothes officers who patrol the streets, who look and make sure they surveil to make sure there's no crimes occurring, and any crime that does occur, they're able to respond like that at a moment's notice. But for Governor Cuomo, for Bill de Blasio, no, that's not important. What is important is that these extremist voters, they make sure they're happy. And let's be real. When you pander to the mob, they're never happy. There's always something else. There's always something more. You defund and you remove $1 billion to our police department, what's next, you're going to say, actually, a billion's not enough. We want $2 billion. We want $5 billion. We want to scrap the entire department. And at the end of the day, what matters is total anarchy for them, as opposed to maintaining law and order in our communities.
I would imagine that the police departments in New York and in New York City, especially, it's not like they have tons of extra money. I mean, this is really going to hurt law enforcement.
I mean, well, let's say this. When people call 911, who's going to respond now? When people say, when now the elected officials that are catering to this leftist mob, when they try to do all this and then it fails, they're going to now rely on the police to respond. And at the end of the day, they won't be enough. Or even worse is the police are going to feel that if they do respond, and for some reason or another, there's a video recording shown that someone's calling on their firing the elected officials, they won't be there to back them. They're going to sell them out. They're going to put their heads on the chopping block. That's how police feel. I mean, I have police in my family. I have police that are my friends. All my district are New York City police officers that live in Long Island and commute to the city. And all of them feel and know that the New York State elected officials, they don't have their backs. They'll sell them out in a heartbeat to get a vote from the leftist mob.
So I would imagine that's, it's hurting morale.
Morale's down. You're going to see, I mean, you saw just a few weeks ago, you saw looters and rioters that were being arrested and then being let back in the street just to loot again. Think about that. What kind of message are you sending to your law enforcement officers? What type of message are you sending to law-abiding Americans that are watching their streets dive into chaos and anarchy?
And also, this sends a message to potential criminals. I mean, they're kind of emboldened.
Well, New York State as a whole has been emboldening community criminals since the cash bail reform, since them allowing people to go back and commit crimes, get arraigned and go released right back in the streets. I mean, you're seeing criminals time and time again commit the same type of crimes. The looters going back, looting retail stores, going back, looting, making different robberies, different burglaries. I mean, this is the time where criminals feel that they have the power because the police, they are the ones that are handcuffed, not the criminals.
Well, I saw a polling, if you believe the polls, it says the majority of Americans don't support this effort to defund police. So you have to wonder what the average New Yorker, the person who is not out on the streets, because I would call that the loud minority. I don't think that that's everyone, but the polling showed, I think, mm-hmm. like only 13% of people actually support the effort to defund police. How do you think this is going to affect elections going forward? New York City especially is known for being very liberal. Do you think it would maybe make independents and old school Democrats think twice about supporting Democrats in the future?
Yeah, I would sure hope so, to say the least. I mean, if you have any sense of any semblance of common sense, you're recognizing that those that are with the left wing extremists recognize that they want to shut down any differing view. I mean, for myself, for example, I've stood with law enforcement time and time again, and I get attacked, I get berated. People try to defame me in any way they can to shut me up, and I refuse. I refuse to capitulate and submit to their shouts and screams, because at the end of the day, that's not what the people want. The people want safe communities. The people want to be able to provide for the family. The people want to be able to go to work and not have to look over their shoulder. But for left-wing extremists, no, they don't care about that. They care about anarchy, chaos, allowing criminals to do whatever they want, and they care, and they'd rather have the rules be stricken and for you to do whatever you decide. That's not how it works in a civilized society.
Well, Assemblyman LiPetri, we're going to leave it here. Thank you so much for your insight. We really appreciate it.
Thank you so much.